Why are we here?
Welcome to our secret base! Wait a second. You don't really want to see the secret base that Nick whipped up for us just yet, do you? Seriously. You mean you'd rather see a super awesome base with crazy arsenal, a giant robot, and... You know what? That sounds awesome, actually. Hold on a second. Wait right here. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere! Oh my god, a super giant robot!
Levi, get out of here.
I just want to touch it!
I said no.
Nick can be a bit of a wet blanket sometimes. Don't mind him. What I'm really here to tell you guys is why I put this little team together. I know it probably doesn't make sense, honestly. An atomic man, a soldier, the world's most powerful wizard, also known as yours truly, and an undercover private eye with the powers of a... You guys haven't gotten that far, have you? Don't worry, you will. Hell, I even tried to get that cool ice dude to join us. Didn't work out. But the reason I'm getting this A-team together is because of the demons. Well, one demon. One really big, smart, scary demon that I may have made. But we'll get to that. Oh, and by the way, if you haven't figured it out yet, here comes the long exposition. So, I wanted to be the world's greatest wizard that has ever existed. Well, I mean, not that I'm not, but that's not the point. Every wizard has their spells that they use often, and the ones they back catalog. I'm a bit of a bookworm, if you guys couldn't tell. Maybe not bookworm. Maybe that's not the right term. Let's say I'm a mystical librarian. That's even worse. Forget it. What I'm saying is wizards always need books to cast spells they don't remember. I wanted to bypass that and retain all that knowledge. The problem is, mortals can't do that, and non-magic sensitive mortals can't even do that. Even less. Less so. Let me break it down for you. Here's you. Average Joe. This is how much space you have for knowledge. It's great, but it's not enough. On the other hand, magic sensitive users like moi can expand their mind and allow more knowledge to be contained. But... like anything, it has its limits. If you go past those limits, you start to enter crazy town. You know, where up is down, black is white. The only ice cream that tastes good is pickles and pistachio. Ice cream. Damn it! Why did you bring up ice cream? We have no time for that! Anyway, the only way for someone to expand beyond that point is... let's say, less than divine alternatives. For example, angels, but they're mostly assholes. Always saying stuff like, I can't do that. I can't intervene in mortal matters and stop crying and get off my leg. But they have brethren of sorts. Demons. Now, demons and angels both can contain infinite amounts of knowledge. Unlike angels, though, demons are greedy. They enjoy mingling with us because we can offer them something. Although, dealing and dealing with demons is sort of a mixed bag when it comes to consequences. Some demons are fine to work with humans at a price, but others are schemers, and that's what this story is about. Steve! I finally figured out a spell that I think will release the demon inside this crystal. I know this isn't the best idea, but imagine what we could do with a demon on our side. It would be like Howl's Moving Castle, Steve. Well, There's no time like the present to try. Here we go. Did it work?
Who has released me from my slumber?
Hello. I'm Levi Ravensight, and I wish to make a pact with you.
A pact?
Yeah. Well, you see, it's a long story, but I want to become the greatest wizard. But to do that, I need infinite knowledge, and I was hoping that we could make a trade for that.
You're very wise already, it seems. You must have a keen eye for demonology. Well, what would you be willing to trade?
I have many artifacts. You could help yourself.
I do not want trinkets. I want something more valuable.
Oh, yeah. Get what you're getting at. I don't think I can part with my soul.
Then you have nothing to trade with me.
Wait. Okay, you may have my soul, but I want to be able to have infinite knowledge. The ability to know everything I read.
Agreed.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to DC Universe Online with our new character. Now, this one is a little bit of a tough one for me, honestly. Had a lot of problems in the past with people not liking me doing Celestial, but I had told you guys that was my plan to do a Celestial character. And our new Celestial character is kind of hard to pronounce, not really, but let's call him Thrax for short, because I want to call him Thrax. I actually played around with his name a lot, honestly, because I just never was satisfied with it. And then I had an idea, and I remembered some pop cultural reference, and I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna call him that. So yeah, if you guys get that reference, put it in the comments, I guess. But, few things to take care of before we start. Actually, let's get out into the world. Right now, Thrax's mentor is Circe. This is the first Circe mentored character that we have done ever, that I've done ever. But I imagine it's not much different than the Wonder Woman. It's just the villain side, but there might be some differences. Clearly a villain, if you guys didn't figure it out. But a few things to take care of before we get started. Actually, I want to share one thing before we go outside. Going to the traits, the powers. Okay. So, using the advanced mechanic for this character, if we were going to do that, I'm going to do a variation of it for now. But you would normally do a blessed loadout, which is like, whatcha? Very bright and pretty. But I really don't want him to have blessed powers. Because he's a demon. He's a bad guy. He's a monster. So I want him to have the curse tree. So it's not going to be the optimal loadout possible. It's slightly weaker than the blessed version. But the other reason is because on the test server now, there is the ability to start testing out the new way powers work. The new, like, loadout system. The new leveling system in the game. Which to me means that probably within the next month or two, hopefully. Hopefully the next month, sometime in January, maybe the end of January, they will actually have pretty much everything figured out for the powers. The new way they're doing powers. Because now, as I explained in a video previously, instead of having all this tree and everything and all this tree, you get to have every single power at your disposal. There's no more power points. You just get all the powers once you hit level 30. And you gain those powers that, or you know, anything extra you want, like the iconic powers, by using skill points. Skill points are going to be the only thing that matters now. There's no longer power points. So all that stuff is going out the window, and I'm probably going to do a video on that. So for now, I really just don't care about the blessed tree. So if you're looking for an optimal playset, not here. We're having fun with this guy because it's going to be fun. And there's a lot of different things that I want to do with him, but let's go out into the city. So I do apologize because my videos have not been at all frequent at all. It's been several weeks, and I do apologize for that. But I've been going through a lot of changes in my life. One big one is, many of you know I'm gay, so that doesn't matter. But for anyone that's new, because I know we've gained a lot of subscribers since the last video, or since I put out that video, since somebody wanted me to talk about it. But I got a boyfriend! Yay! Not that any of you care, but I pretty much share my entire life with you guys. So I figured I'd share that with you. But in the last couple weeks, I've been wooing my mate. Wow, that sounded really creepy. Really creepy, Josh. Super creepy, Josh. I have been trying to woo him and spend time with him. So that's been my focus. I really haven't thought about playing the game or anything. I mean, I have, but not in the, like, I'm going to do that right now sense. So I do apologize. Things are a little bit complicated in my life right now. So yeah, hopefully you guys will be okay. Hopefully.
Those smug signals have taken over Chinatown.
They've taken over Chinatown. Oh God.
Where am I going? Is this? Ow, 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 ow. Why is nobody talking to me? So yeah, I mean, that's like the big, stuff going on in my life right now. Nothing really.
I prefer evil.
A purifying ward in the hopes of trapping the demon lord Trigon in his dimension. His sentinels of magic think their pitiful enchantments can stop us. Show them they are sadly mistaken.
You can't stop all of our warding, scum.
What's another thing I needed to talk about? Oh! So, night falls.
This codex is cold to the touch, like the depths of space.
Ow. Nightfall's still happening, don't worry. Again, just taking some personal time. Something I really don't get to do. You know, like my life pretty much for the last 4 years has been come home, record, and do all that, and then deal with my personal life in the background. So, yeah, I mean, that's just how that's been.
Start. Now, the Sentinel base is guarded by a protective spell, which only grants access to the pure of heart.
The pure of heart.
Brother Blood's cultists. They'll give you something to bypass the spell.
Trying to think of what else has been going on, honestly, with me personally. But not really a whole lot to share with you guys, honestly. I mean, that was the big thing. I just kind of wanted to brag. I gotta be honest. I just wanted to brag. See, I've never done this before. This is totally new for me.
New spell slinger.
Yes.
This will suck the good right out of pure-hearted civilians.
Ooh.
Don't bother using it on anyone else.
Okay.
Now, use that gem to drain essence from the innocent. Enough essence, and you can enter the Sentinel base.
Ooh, can I? Ooh.
Get the demonic waste.
Probably not gonna put a waste on him. Wish I had some of that currency. I could get one of these. I think I might have enough. Hold on, let's see. Let's see, can I open a time capsule? Perhaps. What is it? Supplies?
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, boy, get one of those. Oh yeah, here we go. We go get one of those. Boom, what do we got? We got crap. Lots of crap. That's what we got. We got a bunch of crap.
Alright, well that's great. Totally useless. But the other big thing is, and why I absolutely needed to. Well, I mean, besides me being a total slacker. Hold on, let's get the shiny.
Shiny! If
anyone gives you the incantations in the scroll are difficult to make out. Probably for the best.
Demons. Suck demons.
See, the dark power does a whole lot less.
Why are you doing this to me?
Actually, I forget what it is. Is it this? No, what is it? This and then, yes, that's what it is. So if you tap the melee button, it does a whole lot more damage. Forgot about that. It's got the combo system, which makes Celestial awkward to use, but it's still pretty fun. It's gonna be really fun when you get to kind of just do whatever you want with the powers. And since you have every power, if they stick with the whole like. Having two powers is necessary. That means that every power, because see the ways of the Celestial Chi. Oh God, who's hitting me? Stop hitting me. There you go. The way the Celestial Chi tree blah, 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 works is so I have Smite, but to do the combo for it, which makes it corrupted, I need to do also the curse tree and vice versa. But with the new thing coming out, once you hit level 30, all these, if they keep that combo system, which I imagine they will keep the combo system, and that you need those, the cleansed, call upon cleansed spirits to seek out your enemies, dealing damage. To do that, the whole cleansed or corrupted thing, you'll need both sides, and you'll have that, so any power can be used whenever, so you can do pretty much whatever you want. I'm so excited for the new, way they're doing the powers, because it's gonna be so good, you guys! This is what Dcuo needed from the very beginning, let's be honest. Like,
and who are you supposed to be?
Like, it was good in the very beginning, when they didn't, like, mess with the powers too much. But then, when they got, like, start adding all the stuff that they do to the powers, then it got really funky, real fast. Got real funky, real fast. So, I feel like this is a change that was needed, like, a long time ago. I think the cleansed version is this, and then it's range? No, it is melee. And then, yeah. So it would do, like, not scary skulls. It would do, like, pretty
instead of skulls. I like the skulls though. There you go. There you go, buddy. A little bit of skull action for ya.
Yeah, I'm so excited for the changes they're doing to combat. It's gonna be so much better. And I talked about it in the video. Sorry, I wanted to talk about other things this video, but I got into this subject, so that's where I'm at. But I know they're doing it so that you can play the character any way you want, and that's great. But it's only great if a lot of powers do exactly the same thing. Let's be honest. That's the only way it's the best. Because the problem with, like, the stuff they could have done now is great because you could have found variations that worked very well for what you needed. But with sort of any like MMO or like game, there's always like an optimal way to play it to deal the most damage or to do the best healing or to do the best of everything.
You need to enter the Sentinel's base. Go there now and take what is rightfully ours.
Okay. I need to do this one.
Quacha! Get away.
I need to whack the wards. I think they're on the roofs. Roofs, rather. But yeah, with any game, there's like the best combo of weapons. But if they do this right, then you can use a whole bunch of variations to deal the same amount of damage. That's what I hope comes from this. And if you guys want to try out the powers and you are on PC, then you can go onto the test server and play around with it right now, which I will do in a video and talk about it at a later date. Right now there's only a certain amount of powers, but eventually every power will be testable on there. Or testable. I don't know. But yeah, eventually you'll be able to test everything and it won't really matter. So yeah, but if they do it right and we all test the powers perfectly and do it right, we can have really, really good combat system, which is not affected by,
you have all the
updates.
You need to enter the Sentinel's base. Go there now and take what is rightfully ours.
Go to the Sentinel's base. Didn't see what the
demon belt looked like.
Probably, again, like I said, probably not gonna put a belt on him. Oh yeah, I have Death's Head.
I'm not feeling it.
It's cool, but not what I want. Not what I want for this guy. Where is that? Oh, it's right there. Okay. But yeah, besides that, a bunch of Christmas stuff coming up. Not really a whole lot coming up with the game. Sorry! No! Get back here! I want you all to die! Oh, they got out. I think there's some sort of feat if I killed all them. Traits. Feats. Deeds. Feats! Nope. Solo. Hideouts. Or is it in general? General? No. Solo. Hideouts. Unless it's iconic battles. No. Survival? Maybe. No. That's survival. Okay. Contacts? Nope. Hideouts. Okay. It's gotta be in here. It's gotta be one that I haven't gotten because I haven't been here before. Convert. I still gotta do that one. Redirect all the portals. I think we can do that in here. defeat. No. Okay. So nothing really exciting, but still stuff that we can do, which is great. I would have figured there would have been like, kill all the citizens, cause you're evil, type thing. But one of the big things that I wanted to talk about, because I've been so behind on The Flash, Gotham, and Legends of Tomorrow, and Arrow, and Supergirl. I pretty much got caught up with everything, you guys. And yeah. So I know before I was like, all right, we're gonna go episode to episode. Not gonna happen. Way too much stuff for me to remember. Gotta be honest. But what I want to talk about is I want to talk about the most recent episode of The Flash. Not the one tonight, which would be yesterday, because this video always comes out the next day. But you guys usually know what I mean. But the video or the episode before that, like the early December-ish, like second week of December type thing. I don't know what that would be. What would it be? It'd be like the 8th. I don't know. Something like that. I want to talk about that, and I want to talk about the crossover. Maybe not so much what happened in it, but I just want to talk about it, because if you guys haven't seen it, whoosh, spoilers. You guys know how this works. You know I'm going to say spoilers. You don't want to be spoiled. But the crossover episode, which, I mean, it was still really cool. It was still really cool. I gotta be honest. But it was Invasion. And if you never read that, like, it's a 4-part series, I think. Yeah, 4 parts. It's about the Dominators, and they come to Earth, and they try to take out the metahumans and stuff. In the book, there's a lot more alien races and stuff that are involved in it. Rather than just them. It's also got like Green Lanterns. And it also involves Apocalypse and Darkseid. Darkseid's always after the anti-life equation. I think that's what it's called. And unfortunately, he really doesn't want people destroying Earth, because he needs Earth to figure it out. So they have to get like permission to go there and take out the metahumans or whatever, or try to anyway. But the thing I really wanted to talk about, okay, it was across all three of the main series, not including Supergirl. Supergirl only had a part in it because Barry went and got her from her Earth, but it doesn't affect her Earth, so it didn't matter to her Earth, which I'm okay with that, because that's a lot of stuff to have go on one Earth. Is Supergirl with her alien stuff going on, and then you got the Flash with like future and past stuff happening, and you have Arrow with Prometheus, which is fucking awesome, and you have Legends of Tomorrow, and they have Citizen Steel, and they're going up against like time itself, and they're going up against Thawne and Damian Dark, and oh my god, you guys, there's so much stuff happening. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous how much stuff is happening, but it has nothing to do with Supergirl. It only happens to the other people in the team. And it was really cool. It was really cool to see them do everything. But I have some nitpickiness about the whole thing.
The Eye of Sin is protected by 3 flames of containment in the nearby antechambers. Reposition the flames to steal the eye.
All right. To reposition the eyeball, or whatever, and I need to do something with the these portals.
I warn you, do not cross me.
Something like, is it this? Ooh, activate. Ooh, interesting.
I shall resist your evil.
Will you? Will you resist my evil? Am I that evil? Is there a portal in there? Ah, there is a portal in here. Alright. Excuse me! You have a portal! Ow! Stop hurting me! I'm the bad guy! You're not allowed to hurt the bad guy. Yay. Shoop. And turned off. Yay! Ooh, there's a lot of these portals. Alright, gotta turn them all off. Turned off. And turned off. Cool. Okay, so I have some problems with it. It was great, but there were some things about it. I'm gonna put you right here in case it, like, does something. I've never done this before. This is all new. All new to me, you guys.
We can't let the shield be breached.
Can you not? I mean, it'd be really easy to allow it to be breached.
Turn from the dark path.
No, I like the dark path. Also, demon. Okay. So the first episode of The Flash, like the first part of it, of the whole invasion thing. So the entire season, Barry's been dealing with the effects of Flashpoint. He's been dealing with that. And everyone is pretty pissed off at him, like in general. People are pretty pissed off at him for screwing up the timeline. And like Cisco's really mad because apparently what Barry did killed his brother. Barry didn't kill Cisco's brother purposefully, but it happened. It happened anyway. And his brother died. I hear Glowy, where is it? I hear you, Glowy! Come to me! Tell me your secrets! Ooh, this is pretty. PC, get on it! I want swirly thing in the ceiling! I think I've told them before that. Oh, I really want the thing from the Dr. Fate. Like his sanctum. The Dr. Fate sanctum. That one's real cool. So Barry's been dealing with all this, and it's kind of ruining his friendships, and everyone's mad at him, and he can't do anything about it. And in the first episode, aliens come. There's, like, no real lead-up to it, which makes it awkward watching, like, the other series and stuff, like Arrow, because it just changes over to this crossover event. But we'll get to that in a second. But everyone's been mad at Barry, and in the first, like, part of the crossover, the Dominators... Ah, here's the shiny.
Shiny.
I've read this lexicon twice and can still only ask where the bathroom is.
Oh, well, I guess that's fine. Is there anything to do with these? Oh, I can break them. That's about it. So everyone gets their mind taken over by the Dominators. Because they want control of the metahumans for reasons. Probably because they're powerful and can do that. Some people are taken over by them because they go to a place where the president is and he's being held captive. And they get their minds taken over and then they have to go fight the rest of the team. Which doesn't really turn out very well because it's like Barry versus Supergirl and I think it's literally just Barry and, Ollie, because they stayed behind because everyone was pissed off at Barry, except Ollie. And Ollie, I gotta be honest, he was the godsend. I mean, it was not that it was bad or anything. It was just, he was Batman for this entire thing. Because I think the original story takes place with, like, the Justice League and everything, and it's got all them. So he was basically Batman of this whole thing, telling Barry, you didn't do anything wrong. I mean, you made a mistake, and mistakes happen. talking Barry through this, always being at Barry's side, which was great. It was so awesome. And there goes my phone.
Just so you know, the Eye of Sin is not Trigon's actual eyeball. In case you were wondering.
Oh. I wanted Trigon's actual eyeball. Could you imagine that? Be huge.
Eye of Sin. Use it to corrupt mortal souls into wrath demons. And tip the balance in Chinatown back to us, where it belongs.
Okay, you can do that. So yeah, Ollie was stayed by Barry's side, but then they had to try to defeat, you know, the team and then try to fix things. And they had Felicity and all those guys. Helping, you know, team Ollie, which is also kind of weird, but I mean, that's been the whole season.
You fear Trigon's power? Perhaps you think him too strong. Coward. You and your sad little sentinels don't stand a chance. The balance is tipping fate. Watch your step.
But I'm also really digging team Ollie because it's got Ragman in it. That's awesome. I was so excited when they added Ragman. You have no idea. So happy. At first I thought, his design's a little bit different. So at first, because he looks very much like Scarecrow, I was like, are they doing Scarecrow? Like, because he inflicts fear on people, sort of. Or he was, anyway. And I was like, this is a very strange Scarecrow. But thankfully it turned out to be Ragman. And I was like, yes! Ooh, there's a shiny. Shiny!
Lois Lane with Daily Planet Live. The Department of Metahuman Affairs today confirmed that the Sentinels of Magic will be combating villainous magic here in Gotham and beyond.
Oh god, things are freaking out.
Master Sorcerer Dr. Fate and the Justice League Star Magician Zatanna. Look for their magical wards and spells throughout the city.
Game's freaking out for some reason. I don't know why. It don't matter.
The last grimoire was a limited edition.
It was a limited edition. Cool. I was looking for like the side questy guy, but I don't see a side questy guy. Wow, that was terrifying. Also kind of sexy. There you go. I really wish they updated these guys to the ones that are in Gotham Wastelands. It always bothers me because they said they would and they never did. Whatever. What are you gonna do? I figured it would just be like switch this ID for this ID, but clearly not how it works. Josh is not a programmer and cannot make games. That is fact. But so they end up like fixing everything in the first part, and then everyone on the team, because of the situation, is like, don't worry Barry, we're on your side, but only to a point with certain people. But other people like Diggle. Diggle was a little bit upset because he had a daughter originally and now has a son. But in the end, it just becomes like a non-thing. So I don't... I felt like it was a non-thing in the beginning because he wouldn't have... I guess it's a non-thing. So I guess that worked out. But it bothered me because in the first episode, like, this whole thing happens. And then they're just like, we're a team. We're together, don't worry. We'll never leave your side or whatever. So it just felt kind of weird and kind of like awkwardly done. As was the second episode, which had them get kidnapped. The team at the end of the first episode, they get kidnapped by the Dominator, some of the team. And it's a lot of Ollie, like Team Arrow, dealing with the past through this weird machine that allows them to, like, it it like uses all their memories and all their knowledge to create scenarios in which they live in, like an alternate reality where everything's perfect and wonderful. But they very quickly like understand what's going on. But the one thing that bothered me about it, because I mean, it was very touching. It was like seeing like what your life could have been if you hadn't become the arrow and fucked everything up. Because I mean, let's be honest, that's actually what happened. Ollie pretty much fucked everything up by becoming the Green Arrow. I mean, that's how it happened in the TV show. You can't deny facts, folks. Ollie screwed up. But there's a part at the very end when they all decide they're leaving. And I warn you, do not cross me. Actually, there's a few things. Okay, so they're talking about how the hologram alternate reality world is going to try to keep them there by using like their memories to stop them. But it doesn't really try to do that. Like, even the final fight inside of it, it's just like they have Damian Dark going up against White Canary, and she's
adore wrath demons, so strong and yet so stupid. Impose your will on them and direct their rage at the Sentinel stronghold.
Words. And he's basically like, I'm gonna enjoy killing you less than your sister and stuff like that. And it's like, well, if you're trying to like keep them there, that's not gonna do it. It's gonna bring back more of those memories that you're trying to like trying to suppress. That's the right word. Those memories that you're trying to suppress that they have. So it's not gonna like fix it. I know I'm just killing stuff, but I wanted to go this way just to see if there was a side mission. I'll see a side mission, so I'm gonna go this way. But yeah, it is like, it made no sense to me. Like, why it would do that? You know what I mean? Why would it do that? And not just, ooh, that was weird. There's a thing over there. I think it was one of the demon holes. Demon holes! What do I do with these? Did I break these? Ray!
Lead me into battle, master!
Okay.
The sentinels of magic will fall. Together we will
destroy. Can I just get all these?
Yeah, level 7.
Can I get more? Get all the demons. All of them. Sorry, dude. I took a whole bunch of those. So yeah, that bothered me. And then also, okay. I cannot do flight yet. Weapons. I don't think I can do flight yet. Can I? No. Level 9. Let's see this one. We'll just go straight down. What is my mission here? Just kill these guys. Okay, great. Like, I needed demons to do that. I am a demon. I don't need more demons to do my job.
Wrath demons. Nice. Call me when sloth and greed show up. Now those are my kind of guys.
Ooh, shiny.
Now, to destroy the Ankh of power inside the Sentinel base. Use the orbs inside to summon demons against the Sentinel's pathetic shields. Once the Ankh is drained, Brother Blood will join you to defeat Fate himself.
Okay. Can you hurry up and grab this?
This text's very pages are protected by powerful enchantments.
Yay. Seriously, what do you got to tell us?
Welcome to Big Belly
Burger. It's Big Belly Burger.
Have a belly busting day.
I think there's another one around here. Aha! Miney! It's Miney!
I am Jack Ryder, and you are wrong. Why? Because hell on earth is coming, friend. You think the Cult of Blood is a harmless little club? Ha! They worship the demon Trigon, an interdimensional baddie who spawns sin like garbage breeds flies. Demons are already rampaging in Metropolis. Trigon is coming. You don't believe it? You are wrong.
You are wrong. All right. I'm sure Cersei's going to talk when we get in here, probably. Probably. And disrupt my conversation with you guys. That girl looks so grumpy. He's just so grumpy. Nope, no talk. No talk. Just go for it. All right, cool. But as they're leaving this alternate reality, Ollie looks back and there's all his dead relatives and friends and everything, and they're all telling him, "You can do it. You made the right choices. You're the best, Ollie. Go take him out." And oh, I've been through this like a bajillion times. This is where I got the pants for Frostbreaker. But not this version. It's like the alert version or the solo version. Use my powers to destroy everything.
You shall fall as well.
Very powerful. This power. It's very powerful in the right. Used correctly. Seriously? Bam. But they're all there and they're like, "You can do it, Ollie." Okay. See, I want this. I want this. Devs! Devs! Devs, give me this! Give me the swirly thing!
I want it! It's so cool!
Look, there's a thing. One of the bites. The bits. Right here. It's floating around. See it? See the bit? Bit floating around. And there's like a sun. Ooh, and there's... No, that's the same bit. Just floating around. In here. And there's this like... green ball, and the red ball, there's a tiny blinky ball, then there's a planet. So cool. Swirls. Oh, and then there's a thingy, a swirly thing.
So swirly and flickery.
Ooh, and a purple ball, with another smaller purple ball floating around the yellow ball. Oh, that's so cool, I want this. Devs, get on it. I want them at a base. But that is... it. Okay. It's very touching. But it makes not a lick of sense why this, like, alternate, like, mind brainwashing, alternate reality type machine would suddenly be like, "You can do it. Be best." Like, I don't understand that. It didn't make any sense. And also, I just don't think, like, the whole thing really mattered to the story. It didn't really, like, fix anything. Like, where it got really good is in the Legends of Tomorrow episode, which was the finale of it. I mean, the beginning was really good, like, getting the team together. Yeah. Them fighting. Yeah. Resolving it. Not so much. This thing. Not so much. Really boring. But then you get the legends in, and they're like, "We got this, we can fix all this shit." But that explored like a whole lot of other stuff. Like, for instance, because Barry messed with the timeline, well, actually, I think it was more due to Professor Stein's meddling with the past self that he was, in encouraging him to be more loving to his wife. Kind of janked up the timeline, and now he has a daughter, and now he doesn't want, like, at first he didn't want his daughter because he's like, "I don't know who this person is. It's not a real person. I made an aberration in time. This is an aberration," because that's their whole, the legend's whole thing. Alright, let's go take on Dr. Fate. Dr. Fate! Ooh. Hold on, Glowy.
An important historical find in the field of syncretism.
Ooh, this would be cool too, but there's no way they're gonna make that.
Who dares to desecrate this sacred stronghold?
I do. The demon Thrax.
Today, you and your sentinels will fall.
My wing's going through your chest. Blood, I'm sorry. Let's just batter him with power. Oh yeah, this part I have to like run around in a circle basically. And just dodge those explosions. That's pretty much all I have to do is dodge those. Really, really easy, especially when you have super speed. When you're a speedster in this, it's super easy. Super easy to dodge. Oh gosh. Alright, Fate, you wanna fight? You gotta fight. Ow.
Antion, Anubi, Necronius.
Yeah. The I should be defeating him right now instead of flopping around.
Antion Anubi Bastios.
No, he's actually not like, oh, there he goes. I was waiting for him to like be like, I'm about to fight back. Yeah. So he has a daughter now. And he didn't want the daughter, and then he got to know the daughter, and loves the daughter now, and doesn't want her to disappear, so he can't tell anybody. Him and Jax can't tell anybody that his daughter exists, because otherwise, everyone's gonna be like, well, you gotta get rid of her.
Your victory is temporary, blood. That much is constant.
Ooh. Ooh. I'm gonna go with the legs. The legs are a little bit more powerful. Ooh, and I got a mission box. Mission box! Boop. And hands. And feet.
And waist, which is less good. But I still got it.
Demon legs. Oh my god. Awesome. Alright. Blood, talk to me.
With Fate and his Ankh defeated, the door to Trigon's dimension
opens. Check out that demon butt.
When Trigon rises,
so much demon
butt. I remember the part you played.
In a very purple naked man. Cutscene!
As a lord of order, I have walked countless worlds, witnessing the birth and death of a million civilizations. And in the course of the eternal battle, I have learned it is the fate of some to destroy, and of others to defend. Sometimes fate decrees that worlds live, and sometimes that their ends be bleak and tragic. I am Dr. Fate, and I stand at the threshold between light and dark. Now, as the scales tip from order to chaos and back again, I too must ask, what fate awaits us now?
Fun fact, I'm a Libra, so I'm the scales. I really like that. You know, dark and light, always keeping everything balanced. I always like that idea. Yeah, so that happens, and I think Citizen Steel gets his suit. Then they defeat the Dominators in kind of a doofy way. But all in all,
level Dr. Fate.
I know.
Of order, you know.
I know.
Be keeping you real busy.
Okay. I think I need admonish.
It is done. With the Ankh drained, the door to Trigon's dimension opens.
You need him.
Blood's cultists prepare the ritual even now.
Get the blight version as well.
Meet Brother Blood at the safe house for your reward.
Damage! I need to move this to here. And I move this one. Wait. Wait, which one was which? I need... Smite is the bad one. Or the good one. The bad one. I need Haunt, and then I need Smite. And then I need... Blight. Or no. Hold on, I gotta go look at the powers again. Curse Tree. What is it? Blight. Oh no, I need... Just Haunt, and then Blight. Okay. Gotcha. Loadouts. Damage. I need Haunt. And then I need... Blight. And then I need... Smite. And then I need... Munish. Alright. They good? Yeah. So this would be like... Boom. 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 Yeah, like that. So there you go. That's, I think that's the first part of the whole thing. Boom. Boom. Oh, I don't have enough power. Get some power in here. Boom. 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 And then shotgun blast.
Shotgun blast to your ass, mother trucker.
Everything all together. It was very cool. It was very cool to see Invasion, which was something I did not expect. And I think that's why I didn't like it as much as I thought I would. Not that it wasn't good. It brought up a lot of things. It resolved some things. It caused more problems. But previous seasons, like Flash Season 1 and Flash Season 2, when they started doing these crossovers, it was all to link the series together into like one idea that happens, and then that idea gets expanded throughout the shows in some form of another. You know, one series would have something happen. Now, granted, the Invasion did bring up ideas that are part of all the shows, and people dealing with specific things. Let's go talk to Brother Blood.
Yes, Trigon will rise. Even now, his demonic energy manifests through his daughter, Raven.
Yay!
The Titans
Boom!
Are attempting to stop it, but I think you will stop them, won't you?
Oh, I will stop Trigon. Them. I didn't know it was that exciting.
I am delighted with you. Trigon's energy is free to enter into this plane through his daughter, the so-called hero, Raven. Trigonic energy is corrupting human souls across the Tomorrow District. Join the demon rampage and show these ridiculous science police what magic can be.
Oh, Tay. Need to go get rid of some of this junk. And check my mail! Oh, this episode is not done, you guys.
You might think it's done, but it is not done yet.
You guys have not had an episode for a long time. I'm gonna make the best of this.
Bleh.
Is this that thing? I don't know. I think I have this, the Wonder Woman emblem, but I am not gonna use it because last time it janked everything up. But I am gonna put that on. Ring. What was I gonna say? Oh, it brought up ideas, but nothing in the episode had anything to do in general. Ooh, I should talk to Agent Zeal too. Brainiac Agent Zeal!
Going down on our city, and the cops
Brainiac, we should do the Brainiac one, because that one's real easy, and it's right next door. Journal.
Calculator here. Ready to get some revenge on the genius who planned to digitize your powers?
Sure.
Let's stomp some cans.
Okay.
The X forces are making a push into the city. Head Ooh. Over there and hold the line.
Sounds good. But it had nothing to do with the series. It had nothing to do with the villains or anything. Like, last season it brought up, it brought in, Legends of Tomorrow, and they had to deal with, the fudge is his name. Uh, Savage. Vandal Savage, that was his name. So they brought in that whole thing. And then in the first season, it brought up, like, Barry doing stuff. Anyway. But they all kind of, like, linked into, like, what the story was. And then they went their separate ways. And that was pretty much it.
Defend blood's sanctum from these clockwork.
Oh, yeah. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, I forgot to hold down. Whatever. But this one had nothing to do with it, unless it's bringing in the idea of alien races attacking. But I feel like Supergirl's doing that, so it feels like a pointless thing. You know what I mean? So this pillar is like perfectly flat right there. So is this one and this one. Why are there perfectly flat pillars? Should all be like broken, mangled. Whatever. It's modeling. Modeling happens like that. Quacha. Out. That's very powerful. But not as powerful as doing this. Ow. Said doing this, and then this, and then this, and then this. Oh, I think that one's backwards. I think that's the one that's backwards. I think it's tap range and then melee. This one's, and then, nope. This, then that. Nope, it's the same. But that one does like the opposite. You start out with the explosion, or like the shotgun blast, and then you go into the explosion. Alpha protocol. Target. Watch out! I'm gonna whack you guys. I don't actually need any more of these guys.
Brainiac knows we're onto him now. He's jamming some of my signals. Hang on.
Gills. Right, can I get flight yet? Oh yeah.
The bad news is that he's capturing exobyte targets. Take some of those poor slobs to the transport drop-off.
I think I'm gonna skip that one. Weapons. Barrage enemies with a finishing move after quick. I'm gonna do this one. Because I don't think I really have that one. Which one was that? Spin chop? No. It was spin chop. Yeah. Okay. I forget where I was. I do that a lot. If you haven't figured it out, my brain is like a scuttled mess of problems. Grab you while I think what I need to think about. Oh yeah. So, like, it didn't actually, like, the Dominators had nothing to do with what's going on in any of the series. They just didn't. They had, like, no effect on anything that was going on. Which bothered me, because I was like, man, that would be cool if they brought in, you know, now they bring in Darkseid and Apocalypse, oh my god, but I don't think they can, because their movie series is doing that. Possibly later they can bring something in, I don't know. They got all sorts of stuff going on. But, yeah, it just, I was like, it like, affects nothing, this thing. It only affects, like, their relationships, which I guess is fine, but oh well, what are you gonna do? But, all in all, it was really cool. And it was cool to see the Dominators, like, as they are. The thing I love about all the series is they really stick to, like, the style of the characters, you know? I mean, other than Arrow Season 1, where they played around with the idea of having, you know, like, variations on the original characters' designs. Like, Count Vertigo was, like, a younger dude. But all in all, it was really cool to see that. But I want to move on to the Flash, because the Flash has been getting real good, you guys. Getting real good. So all this season has been dealing with the fallout from Flashpoint, which Legends, funny enough, is kind of also picking up the slack from. Because in Legends, they have Thawne and Damian Darhk, like a past Damian Darhk, which is like a remnant in the timeline, because he's technically dead in the future, but he still exists in the timeline.
Yeah, that made him mad. He's on to us. Hang on.
Now I can fly super fast. I'm so happy. Yeah, super flight. Wow.
Fascinating system, which should... Oh, never mind. Brainiac's bombing down troops and supplies for his invasion. He'll start bottling any moment unless you stop him.
Okay. Figured like he already did that. Words that are great. The Flash has been getting really good. So, again, all the fallout and everything. But, also Barry is dealing with, like, some other problems. And, okay, I talked about it a little bit through the entire thing, talking about Dr. Alchemy and everything. And I was pretty sure whatever that dude was before was going to be Dr. Alchemy, but clearly not. I was wrong about that. There's the other forensics guy that Barry has been hanging out with and having to work with throughout the entire season, named Julian. Julian... I need to look up his name. Hold on! Doing research! Julian... Albert... Desmond. That's his last name. So he goes by Julian Albert Desmond. Well, throughout the entire series, like, I imagine there's one part where they mention, like, his full name, or he was like, I'm Julian Desmond, or something, some crap like that. Or it was on his desk, like, his name tag. I didn't catch it, because I just figured, but the character, I was like, oh my god, this character is, like, very, oh, I need to destroy the communication rays. That would be smart if I were actually doing what I'm supposed to be doing, wouldn't it? So I was like, man, this actor seems very familiar, and he seems like he is definitely not just a, like, side character, because clearly he's got some sort of use in this whole thing. Everybody's dead from my demonic powers. Turns out the guy playing Julian is Draco Malfoy from Harry Potter, which is hilarious, because in the Killer Frost episode where
target coordinates transferred.
Forget her first name. I always get her and Felicity mixed up for whatever stupid reason.
Nice. You need to target the communication arrays blocking my signal. I'll remember that.
Now, anyway, the Snow becomes Killer Frost in that, but then they change her back because, I don't know. I would have really loved them to just go full on with the whole Killer Frost thing. I thought that would have been great. But, sadly, they did not do that. But words, where was I with the whole, oh, in that episode he gets punched in the face, and also in the Harry Potter series, I think it's like, it's the one with time travel, but Hermione punches him in the face. And I was like, oh, man, this poor actor. Forget his name. I forget everyone's name. I suck with names. I'm horrible with names. I'll admit it. I have a problem with names. But I was like, this poor actor, his only role is to get punched in the face by people. He actually, oh no, he doesn't get punched by Snow. He gets punched by Barry in the face. So at least it wasn't a girl this time. Not saying anything like girls can't punch guys in the face. Just saying, you know.
Cops, heroes, and now freaking Brainiac.
Yay! Us, huh? Pendant. It's something. What are you gonna do? We checked the mail and everything, right? Yeah. Kinda wanna do... Let's do one of those again while I talk. But it turns out that his full name is Julian Albert Desmond. The guy who is Dr. Alchemy is Albert Desmond. But this episode brought up like a lot of like weird changes sort of to like the story of Dr. Alchemy and everything. Who would I get? More crap. But it turns out he's not actually Dr. Alchemy. He's being possessed by Savitar. And Savitar is super cool because his name is based after the Mayan god. The Hindu god of speed. So he is the god of speed, faster than all the speedsters, because he is speed itself. Sort of. He's just very fast and goes up against Barry. So that's kind of what the whole season's been building up through, is that he's going to have to face off against this new terrifying speedster who's going to try to destroy his life because Barry fucked with the time stream and screwed everything up. Because Barry's really good at that, you know? He's really good at fucking up the time stream. But, I mean, you know, he could also fix things, but then it creates aberrations, and then the legends have to come and fix the aberrations because Barry keeps screwing up time. Just saying, you know, but if Barry does the right thing, then I think it works out. Also, Barry got to go to the future for the first time in the entire series. Normally, he goes back in time. And then stays back in time and then fixes things in the future, which technically, if you think about it, what do I have to do for the Raven one? We're doing Raven.
I am delighted with you. Trigon's energy is free to enter into this plane through his daughter, the so-called hero, Raven. Ha! Trigonic energy is corrupting human souls across the Tomorrow District. Join the demon rampage and show these ridiculous science police what magic can be.
Oh, yeah, I know what I gotta do for this one. Not that I haven't done it a million times, but villain side's a little bit different than the hero side, so, you know. Whack. Whack. Oh. There you go. Where was I at? Oh, yeah. So, no, wait, where was I? I was with, oh, yeah, the time stream. So,
evil energy is manifesting in dark orbs.
Talking here, Cersei.
Corruption cast by Trigon's demons and add to his might.
Technically, if Barry's going back to the past and fixing that variation, that means he has created several like offskirts of the main time stream already. So technically Flashpoint was just like another like tree off the time stream. Also, we got to see Jay come back, which was great because he got to play the daddy role, but also like the best friend role, which was great to see Jay. And we got to see Mr. Hamill play the Earth 3 trickster. So if you guys were thinking, oh, he's going to play the Joker, you're wrong. He just played like a more doofy looking trickster than he already had. It was like a weird version of him where he's like a billionaire or something.
Holiday season full of charity and mistletoe.
Oh, I can do the Yuletide.
Science police is their own superpowered force, including magic. Kinda cute that they think they can take out Trigon. Or you.
Oh, that's great. Am I level 9 already? Oh, I'm level 10. Holy smokes. I mean, I get to go to the Watchtower? Probably not. But I think I can go to the Watchtower. Hold on, I wanna go back. Because I wanna also go look at the, the holiday vendor for you guys. Then we'll handle that stuff later in a different episode. Ooh. So yeah, I was dealing with that, and then he went to the future, and then Jay brought him back, and Jay's like, you can't see that because you're gonna fuck with time again. And Barry's like, but I can fix things. And he's like, Jay's like, you're already gonna fix things because you make decisions in this timeline. And Barry's like, ah, now I understand. All in all, it was really, really good. It was super good. Also, we got to see Sisko get kind of taken over by Savitar. That's how it ended. But just all in all, like, this whole thing is getting really cool. Kind of sad that Julian isn't actually Dr. Alchemy, but that might change later on. He might get the Philosopher's Stone, which is where Savitar is, like, that is his power. That is what he's from in this story, is he is the Philosopher's Stone, sort of, or trapped within it. And then they put it that inside a box, which traps him inside the box. And then they threw that into the Speed Force, which apparently doesn't work out. Don't know why they thought it would, but apparently it doesn't work out. I'm betting them throwing it into the Speed Force breaks him out of that thing, and now he becomes speed itself. Pretty sure. Also, I really want to see the black speedster, the Black Flash, the Flash of Death, which was the fake Jay Garrick in the previous one, and he played Zoom. Oh my god. Oh my god, you guys. Can I not go to the Watchtower? Oh no, I can. Hall of Doom. Cute. Hopefully it doesn't start the whole Hall of Doom thing. Might? Doubt it. I think I have to finish the Raven mission before I can actually do that. Oh no, I get to go talk to... Oh no, that is what I need to do. Sinestro! Sinestro! I actually don't want to talk to Sinestro right now. We'll do that next episode. What I wanted to show you guys was... Okay. So, what I planned for Thrax and what Calvin, who is a lot of characters. I'm sorry, Calvin. I always forget your characters. I apologize. But he's so kindly... gave me a brother blood hood, and a brother blood hood would look so cool. We should actually go look at it. Wee, excuse me, everyone. Oh my god, it is laggy. Very laggy. Hold on. All right, there we go. Now we're in some other menu, so things are less laggy. Not really. Head. Can I look at it through here? Or am I too low level? I'm too low level. Go do this. Brother blood. Preview. Nope, that's not it. That's a brother eye helmet. Do we not have brother blood in here? Brother blood. Brother blood. Brother. Really? 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 Thought it was in here. Nope. 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 rider.
Wow, really?
That's crazy that it's not in here. Huh. I would have thought there would have been Brother Blood Helmet in here. Brother Eye, Captain Cold, Maniac Joker. Curious. Either way, okay. So it's gonna give him a skull face if I do this. Maybe we'll look at it next time. But he would have skull face and a hood, which looks really cool. That's what I had planned for him. But I also was, it was mentioned to me that I go the right way into here. Because in the new holiday seasonal event, there is the Krampus hood with horns. I could do this. Now, it's up to you guys. Personally, I think the hood's too big in this version and also too black, and it clips through the Death's chest style. So I personally don't think it works, but if you guys think I should go with that over the Brother Blood helm, then we'll do that. But personally, I think the Brother Blood helm would work better. Also, I don't think the horns are face style. I think they are head style. I think the only face style is the Krampus mask, which doesn't work. So if the horns happen to be a face style, then yeah, I'll do it. But if not, then I won't do it. But let me know, do you think I should stick with doing the Brother Blood helm? Because I think it would look really cool personally. And you'd look more like a monster-y demon rather than just like a big fat guy in a suit. I think it would look really cool on him. And also, we're going to get the druid style legs because they look a lot cooler than these ones. But yeah, that's that. Finish up the whole Flash thing. Since we've done quite a bit and it's going on like an hour and a half, which is longer than normal episode, but I did want to talk about a lot of stuff this time. I'm excited to see what happens with Savitar, because it's clear that Barry is going to have to like become even better. Oh, and also at the end of the episode, they gave Wally his suit. Gave him his suit. Also, Julian is now their friend, which is kind of cool. Snow. I still can't remember her name. Snow. This is Felicity Smoke and I can't remember her name. I suck at her name. Snow, she like is like Cisco's buddy, and they're like the Grinchy people, and they're not having fun. Cisco's starting to like get over his brother, I think. But Wally is being trained by the new Dr. Wells, who is a doof, but somehow is really good at what he does. But it's great. It's great to have Dr. Wells just in it, even if he's like a third version of him. Like the first one, he was fun, but he was also very strict and grumpy. Second one, only strict and grumpy all the time and not very cool and not hip. This one, not smart at all, not grumpy ever, always hip and cool. We got to see the many sides of Dr. Wells. It was great. But yeah, I'm excited to see what happens. I'm going to keep you guys updated. Next time, we got to talk about Legends of Tomorrow and Arrow. Arrow is going to be cool. I haven't seen the most previous the most recent episode, but I'm going to watch it before the next episode so I can talk about it, because we got Prometheus, and oh my god, I want Prometheus more. I love these series because they pick like very unknown characters and make them super cool. Although I really want to see Prometheus with his like crazy mask that he has that's like a computer and his like cape and cowl thing. Oh, I want to see that. I hope they do that. They should, because it just looks so, it looks stupid, but it looks stupid in a cool like futuristic way. And I like that. And also, I can't wait to see what happens in Legends tomorrow, because they're really building up this whole, like, Thawne messing with the timeline. Damien Dark, they're really getting into it, and there's gonna be a new character, and oh my god, and they have Elliot Ness, and oh my god, you guys, you have no idea. I love it. I love it. It's all great. Anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me for this episode. I do apologize for things being so erratic as they have been lately, and they probably will still stay a little erratic, but I'm really gonna try to get back into doing what I do best on here, and that is doing the Let's Plays and talking to you guys. And also, speaking of that, if you guys haven't had a chance, you should really go over to Two Guys Talk Comics, because we just put out another episode talking about Harry Potter, and tomorrow we're going to record a Star Wars episode that's going to be talking about what we think of the new series and everything in the lore. Talking about all that. It's going to be great, you guys. So you should definitely go over to twoguys.comics. It's on the sidebar. I'll put a link in the description. You guys head on over there. It would be mean a whole lot to me if you guys would go over there and subscribe. If we get to 100 subscribers over there, I can actually have a proper URL for it, rather than it just being like a random string of letters and numbers. So if you guys can do that for us, I would be indebted to, not that I am not already indebted to you guys, because you're amazing. But thank you all for joining me for this episode, and I will see you all next time.